think about it.
Think about what?
The movie.
Wait, hold on a second. What? You're not going to tell me that's what you want on a date. Come on now. If you knew this was going to be the last date, I bet you would make a much bigger statement.
All right, fine.
Worse.
Okay, well, what do you want to do now?
Yeah, nothing. Whatever. I don't care.
Jeff, are you okay?
Are you okay?
I'm fine. Just a little worried about you at the moment.
You don't need to worry about me. I tend to think I'm going to be alright.
Who thinks that?
Who thinks what?
Who thinks that?
It's just an expression, Cindy.
Sorry, I'm not familiar with this.
Oh, why am I not surprised? I think I'm trying to be.
You're not making any sense.
Yeah, well, your dress is stupid.
What?
You heard me. Your dress is stupid.
What does that have to do with anything?
Everything, Cindy. Everything. You just don't get me anymore. And you would know, wouldn't you?
What is that supposed to mean?
Oh, dear Cindy, everything has to be so perfect for her. If nothing ever goes her way, it's always the other person's fault to blame. You are never to blame for anything.
I take plenty of blame for the things that I do, and I do not look down on others for being less intelligent.
Ha, come on. We know better than that, Cindy.
A little support here would be appreciated.
I'm sorry. You tell him.
Yeah, she said. Right on, sister.
You're gonna part, Cindy.
And why did this happen?
You're doing your thing. Doing mine. It's time to cut the cord now instead of being bogged down for later.
Bogged down? Well, I'm glad you feel that way, Jeff.
Oh, and why's that?
Because I fully intended on coming here tonight to talk about breaking up.
Sorry, Cindy, but I'm going to be the one who's breaking up with you.
No, I was coming here to break up with you.
Well, if that helps you sleep better at night, then you can tell yourself that. The fact is, I've outgrown you. You were fun for a while, but I need to live my own life. Without you in it.
Cindy, if you don't
you've got your big plans for the future, and there's a good chance I would have only dragged you down.
She wouldn't want to be dragging me down.
You said those exact words, Matt.
I'm going to kill him when I see him.
Don't! I'm glad somebody had the guts to say something.
Oh, I was fully planning on telling you about it. There just wasn't any time.
This was 2 weeks ago, Jeff. We didn't have any time to do this in 2 weeks?
It was important to me that I did it so I didn't hurt you.
So you tell Matt. Knowing he would tell Jamie, he would tell me. But oh, that's okay. The almighty football player would let me down easy?
Okay, that's not the point, you know. And can you please stop throwing the fact that I'm a football player? This, I'm pretty sure, has no bearing on this discussion.
Oh, it has plenty of bearing. You could have just as easily played somewhere else, but you just had to be a Gamecock.
What was I supposed to do? Turn it down? Go play at some other college and spend the rest of my life paying back student loans?
There are plenty of other colleges offering you a scholarship, but you turned it down without a thought once you got a call from South Carolina.
Wait, this isn't about South Carolina. It's about Duke. You're pissed off that I chose South Carolina over Duke.
No, that's not it. It maybe would have been nice if you would have thought about playing somewhere a little closer to Duke.
No, no, that's exactly what it is. You're pissed off that I chose South Carolina over Duke. If I remember, they were offering you a full ride too, or did you just conveniently forget about that?
Oh, I remember, but come on, Jeff. We're talking about getting a degree from Duke University. We're talking different leagues here.
Oh, so I'm just getting a worthless piece of paper from South Carolina, is that it?
Stop it, you're doing it again. The point is, you could have just as easily signed to play at Duke as I could have accepted a scholarship from South Carolina. But we both chose to go to the schools that we wanted to go to, and now we have to live with our choices.
This really isn't bothering you in the slightest bit, is it?
Listen, you jerk! This is the worst thing that I've ever had to do! You have been my life for the past 2 years, and I wouldn't have had it any other way! This is breaking my heart! And here you are, being a typical guy, telling me you care more about the details than the actual outcome!
I know you! You would never do anything impulsive. You plotted out every single little detail in your head while showing the least bit amount of emotion while achieving your goal. Yes, I know I'm top five in my class, and you're on top, but I'd be willing to bet my smarts against yours any day of the week.
Of course you would, because everything has to be a competition with you.
Yes, Cindy, everything has to be a competition with me. I apologize, okay? I'm sorry that I want to make something out of myself. I'm sorry that if I want to be the best at people, I have to be better than them. I apologize, okay? Lord knows you never went out of your way. It was just all handed up to you on a silver platter.
How dare you? I had to work for everything that I got. I didn't get special grades because I was a football player. I didn't get preferential treatment because I was the popular person in school. I had to bust my butt to get everything that I wanted.
And I just coasted through, is that it?
If the shoulder pads and helmet fit!
If the shoulder pads...
And helmet fit. Yes, that's what I said.
That was a bit of a stretch, wasn't it?
You made me angry.
I have trouble finding a helmet that fits.
Stop. It's not funny.
Yes, it is.
Maybe it's a little funny.
It's the funniest thing I've heard all day today.
Hey, stop. It wasn't that funny.
Right, right.
Like the same foods, we like the same movies, we both hate snooty, pretentious people, and we both
sense of taste wasn't as highly as sophisticated as it is now. I like to